Well, I really think you have a lot of paid agitators, professional agitators in here, too. And I see it all over. And, you know, when you see signs and they're all identical, that means they're being paid by a source. You know, these aren't hand-painted signs where people would go to their basement and paint something because they really believed it. These are all signs that are identical. They're made by the same printer. And, you know, when you see that, that means there's somebody at top that's paying or a group that's paying. And they're doing great disservice to the world, but they're doing great disservice to our country.
So that is Donald Trump talking about the protests we see in many college campuses supporting Palestinians' rights to not be murdered. And there's a lot of insanity there. There's a lot of projection there. Donald Trump knows how astroturfed many of the protests on the right are. And that's why he can't see a protest and not see it as a result of astroturfing. But also, I would like to take issue with the idea that these protests are filled with paid provocateurs. And he is saying that as a critique of the protesters. But is that actually what that is? Because he wants you to believe that the protesters are radicals. They're pro-Hamas. They're terrorists. So why do they need paid provocateurs if they're the terrorists? If there are provocateurs going in there to make bad things happen, and I believe that in some cases there are, how would that be to the benefit of those protesting? Every one of the instances of these slogans that seem to be, you know, like supporting violence or violence is used to diminish, to distract from what the protesters are saying. It's never in their favor for that stuff to happen. So if they are there and Donald Trump is saying that they are there, then they are clearly being paid by someone who does not want you to pay attention to what the protesters are doing. I believe that is true. I did not expect that Donald Trump would be on my side in this. But that said, he wants to get a lot out of these protests. He's not even sure exactly what. He truthed, do you think that the radical left lunatics that are causing all the chaos at our colleges and universities are doing so in order to take the focus away from our southern border? Oh, that's an easy one. No, that's stupid. What the hell are you talking about? And I love the idea that he cannot conceive of someone caring so much about innocent civilians being killed that they would protest, that they would put their time into it. They would put perhaps their position in a university on the line. They risk getting arrested. He cannot conceive of a person genuinely caring so much about what happens to another person that to him, it has to be paid by someone. It has to be to distract from something else because he's never actually felt anything that strongly. Sharon, what do you make of this?
Well, I think that Donald Trump has talked a lot about these paid agitators. I mean, look what Antifa was able to do on January 6th. I mean, it was a peaceful protest until they showed up and started defecating and breaking windows and stealing Nancy Pelosi's mail. So he's right to be concerned, as foolish as it sounds. Okay, this is mislabeling. He wants the lie to become the truth. And back to what you said, you know, earlier in the show, the media, mainstream media, is not doing enough to point out false narratives, including by him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 100%. And look, the issue with this, and we sort of talked about it earlier, is he wants to spread all this misinformation about the protesters. He wants people who witnessed that Fox News interview or whatever to have no idea what's actually going on. And the issue here is the media has no interest in providing a check on that because they also want people to not genuinely know why the students are doing what they're doing. And I want to talk about some of what's happened recently. So the LAPD was brought into the encampment at UCLA. There was clashes between counter protesters and protesters. There's video footage. Look, in these sorts of situations, especially happening at night, it is very hard to say exactly what a timeline for these things is, who is responsible for what. That said, there is footage of people throwing firecrackers into the encampments and then what looks like the counter protesters attacking the encampment. And here is the thing. I talked about this in my pre-port when you had at Columbia, you had cops like busting down doors and then rushing in guns drawn. To us, that seems like not only an overreaction, but a buffoonish overreaction. Why do you need your guns? They have not threatened violence. They're not gonna kill the cops or sending all of these LAPD. Why do you need hundreds of cops? But again, you don't need it because it's necessary. You have it because then people seeing it think it's necessary. You see them with drawn guns, you see them with riot gear, and you think, oh, every other time I've seen that, it's because something crazy was going on. I guess something crazy is going on. And if you're the counter protesters, you don't attack the protesters to win the rhetorical battle. You attack them knowing that no matter what happened, no matter who actually started it, the story coming out of it is there was violence at the protests, and that discredits the protesters. Even if they were attacked, you could literally shower Molotov cocktails on them and they would come out of it looking bad, because that's how the media will report it. And that's the context that no one will get, because the media is not going to share it, Sharon. What do you think?
If you could have seen, and perhaps you did, across the cable outlets, which I sampled this morning before heading off to school, it wasn't just what was said. The unrest, which was caused when the police moved in, from what I saw as they were tearing down the barriers and doing what they do. But it was this palpable fear on the presenters, their faces, as they talked about the unrest and the breaking news stingers, and we've got to really watch this. And by the way, what's going on over in Gaza, if we could just get a ceasefire, it will help with some of what's going on these college campuses. And the one parent who took their child out of Columbia University too, because it's just too much. It's just getting to be too much, you know, once Eric Adams, his police force moved in. It's just cherry picking storylines. It's there, but the percentages, the quantity, the proportions, way off.
Yeah. Yeah, and look, those on the other side and in the media will take a sign or an instance of something happening, which will happen. These are protests happening all over the place. There's tons of people, whether it's people who are already ideologically aligned with the movement that go too far or advocate for violence. It doesn't matter if the majority do. It doesn't matter if the leadership want that. You take that and that's what you publicize. And I would ask you, if you're watching this and you don't agree with those protests, I want you to imagine, I want you to do a little thought experiment. Let's imagine that something happens that you care deeply about and you organize a protest. Do you want the image of your protest to be entirely destroyed if literally one thing happens there that you don't agree with? Is that how you should be judged for your protest? Because I got news for you, something will happen. And by the way, in Texas, they've gone way beyond this. I will remind everyone, we reported this at the time. If at one of these protests, someone does engage in violence, even if they're not a part of your group, even if they literally are a member of the other side, you can go to prison as a result of that. If a counter protester walks into the encampment and then throws a rock that hits a cop, the leader of the protest can be imprisoned. That's what the Supreme Court, it's not just that Texas wants to do that. The Supreme Court said they're okay to do that. And again, all of this is happening after years of the right being like, free speech, we're against cancel culture, how dare you demand we be politically correct? And now we're being told every day by the media that college kids saying we don't want more civilians to be murdered is the most threatening thing that has ever happened in American history. And we're supposed to forget that we obviously have as a nation a centuries long tradition of college students organizing in support of issues that they care about. They're not supposed to do that. Not if it's not in line with either the Republican or the Democratic Party. And they've run afoul of both, as well as the media. They're up against literally everything. You talk about like the swamp, you talk about like the establishment. This is what it looks like. That's why the media is being the way that it is. Thanks for watching our video. Did you know that you can support our show by becoming a subscriber? Just click the subscribe button and also ring the bell so that you get notifications when we're live or when we post new content.